गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड द चैप्टर अ स्टोरी ऑफ विलेज पालमपुर. इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड दैट. टुडे वी विल टेक अप द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स ऑफ द टेक्स्ट बुक. सो एवरी विलेज इन इंडिया इज सर्वेड वंस इन 10 ईयर्स ड्यूरिंग द सेंसस एंड सम अदर डिटेल्स आर प्रेजेंटेड इन द फॉलोइंग फॉर्मेट. फिल अप द फॉलोइंग बेस्ड ऑन इंफॉर्मेशन ऑन पालमपुर. So number one is location. So location, it is 3 kilometers away from Raiganj, a big village, and further on to the nearest small town of Shahapur. That is the location. Now total area of the village. Total area of the village is 226 hectares. These all the things are given in your book also. Land use in hectares. So land use. Firstly, we will tell irrigated land. Irrigated land is 200 hectares. Unirrigated, nothing is given, nil. And then 26 hectare because total is 226 hectares. Then facilities, educational facilities, we will write over here 2 primary school and 1 high school. What about medical facilities? 1 government primary healthcare center and 1 private dispensary. What about the market? Some general stores and shops selling eatables. Electricity supply, most of the houses have electricity. Communication, posts, telephone and television. These are the means of communication. Nearest town, that is Shahapur. Raiganj, I have told you, that was a big village. Now, question number 2. Modern farming methods require more inputs which are manufactured in industry. Do you agree? Yes, we agree that modern farming methods require more inputs than traditional farming. It requires inputs like chemical fertilizers, pesticides, pump sets, farm machinery, electricity, high yield varieties of seeds and water supply. Most of these outputs are manufactured in industries. Similarly, water supply is provided by canal and tanks. Next question, question number 3. How did the spread of electricity help farmers of Palampur? So, in many ways it helped farmers. Most of the houses have electricity connections. It is used to run tube wells in the fields. It is used in various types of small businesses, etc. Question number 4. Is it important to increase the area under irrigation? Why? So we can say yes, irrigation facilities are available only to about 40% of the cultivated land area in the country. Rest of the land, 65% of the cultivated land, is still dependent on rainfall for irrigation. It means that the benefit of multiple cropping cannot be achieved by 60% of the farmer in the country. They produce less and so their income is also low. They live in poverty. That's why it is mandatory or it is important to increase the area under irrigation. Now question number 5. Construct a table on the distribution of land among the 450 families of Palampur. That you will do by your own. You will make a table of that, in which you can make in first column and row you will write land in hectares. Then in the other one in front of that you will write number of families. Then question number 6. Why are the wages for farm laborers in Palampur less than minimum wages? So this is a very important question. So the reason is there is heavy competition for work among the farmers. Employment is less and farmers are more. And therefore, farmers have to be content with what they are earning. Land is owned by landlords who desire to earn more and more profit by giving minimum wages. The farmers are illiterate and unaware of the amount of minimum wages set by the government. These are the reasons. Now, question number 7. You can do it by your own. Next, question number 8. Next question, question number 8 we have. What are the different ways of increasing production on the same piece of land? Use examples to explain. So, different measures are multiple cropping, modern farming methods. So what you can write in multiple cropping, you can write it is the most common way of increasing production on a given piece of land. It means when two or more crops are grown on the same piece of land during a year, i.e. you know, for instance, you can write Indian farmers should grow at least two main crops in a year. In India, some farmers are growing third crop also over the past 20 years, such as in Palampur, jowar and bajra are grown and potato is the third crop. And second point, you can write modern farming methods. So production on the same piece of land can also be increased by adopting modern farming methods. So you can write about green revolution also in this point. Then we have question number 9. Describe the work of farmer with 1 hectare of land. So what a farmer does in 1 hectare of land, he plows the fields by bullocks or tractors, sows the seeds by simply sprinkling by hand, waters the field with the help of Persian wheel, sprays the insecticides by manual pumps, cuts the crop by hand operated tools. Now question number 10, how do the medium and large farmers obtain capital for farming? How is it different from the small farmers? Very important question. All farmers require capital during production. They require fixed as well as working capital. The medium and large farmers have their own savings from farming. They are able to arrange for their own capital. They sell their surplus in the market. A part of this is saved and the rest is used to buy machinery and other raw materials to lend it to the small farmers to make more profit. Now, small farmers have to borrow money to arrange for capital. Small farmers, they need to borrow money for capital. They borrow from large farmers, money lenders and traders who supply them various inputs for cultivation. They are charged very high interest rate of interest by these money lenders and traders or even the large farmers. Next, question number 11. On what terms did Savita get a loan from Tejpal Singh? Would Savita's condition be different if she could get a loan from the bank at a low rate of interest? You know, these are specifically given case studies in your chapter. You are supposed to read them. So the answer could be she took loan of rupees 3000 at an interest rate of 24%. See, such a huge interest rate, 24%. She would have to repay the loan in 4 months. She also has to work on Tejpal's field as a farm laborer during the harvesting season at rupees 35 per day. So low wages. The bank could have provided her a loan at a low rate of interest. In addition, she would have devoted more time to her own field of 1 hectare instead of working as a farm laborer for Tejpal Singh. That's why banks are very important. Then, question number 12, you will do it by your own. Then we have question number 13. Question number 13 also you will do by your own according to your choice. Next, what can be done so that more non-farm activities can be started in the village? So at present there are not so many farm activities in the village. Out of every 100 workers in rural areas of India, only 24 workers are engaged in non-farm activities. So which steps can be taken? Supply of electricity in the villages needs to be improved. This will encourage the establishment of small-scale industries. More villages should be connected to the towns and cities through all-weather road transportation and telephonic system. The villages should have markets where goods and services produced can be sold, such as in Palampur, neighboring towns and cities provide markets for milk, jaggery and wheat. So these things can be done to establish non-farm production activity in the villages. So these are the text questions. I have solved them for you. You are not supposed to do them in the notebook. I will put the questions in your assignment slots. From them, those questions are to be done in your notebook very carefully. Thank you, students. Have a nice day and revise the chapter thoroughly. It is a very important chapter.